Hello everybody, Grace Still Blaze, and we're back with more oxygen not included. No time for BS. We got our puffs over here doing things. Now the puffs right now are chill. And that's because the temperature of the base has gone down quite a bit. You can see they like it to be over 29.9 degrees Celsius. And overall in the base, the temperature is quite nice. 26 over there, 26. So it's a little bit cooler than they would enjoy. I've never killed a puffed. Well, I've never killed a puffed, period. I've never had a puffed wandering around the base. So I don't know if they will be okay with this. I mean, I'm not really sure. Like, I don't know how long they can survive. They can survive without food for quite some time. Just kind of wandering around doing nothing. What's the temperature over here? Oh, inside these little pockets here, 31.6 degrees Celsius. I wonder if that's just because of the contaminated water or something. It's very unusual. Not sure why. Regular water over here is 21.4. So, you guys were mentioning to go ahead and start, like, getting a bathroom. Not a bathroom. Well, a bathroom as well. But, like, a shower and stuff. Okay, so the thing I've been kind of... been kind of lackadaisical about the shower is because the showers in this game have been known to, like, steal people's water. I mean, obviously it uses water. But, I mean, it like, makes water go away randomly. Like, just disappear into the nether. And no one knows why. So, I'm kind of, staying away from that. The other thing I wanted to do real quick is this biodistiller. Now, this used to, I don't know anymore. I don't know if they've patched it or whatever. This biodistiller used to be able to feed contaminated water to the electrolyzer, and the electrolyzer would use the contaminated water and make pure oxygen out of it. So I think we're going to go ahead and try that real quick. I'm going to go over plumbing real fast and just see what we've got going on over here. Just going to deconstruct that one little piece of pipe there so that nothing happens. Now, I think as that the way it is, we can go back over to plumbing. Now, I think this used to work, so I guess we'll find out in just a minute. And then we hook this over here like this. Now, I don't think that it will cause the liquid to continue to go out of the electrolyzer. I think it only goes in one way, I believe. I guess we could be, like, super specific. You keep clicking on stuff, by the way, to get to, like, different pipes and stuff. So we'll get rid of this one other little piece of pipe just so that there's nothing in the way at all. And then I'm gonna go ahead and give this a shot. In fact, you know what? Let's go get this stuff done fairly quickly. How's everything going on the food? 11,500 calories. So the food is doing quite well. Everyone... Oh, hold on. Let's go ahead and make sure... Oh, okay. They're just grabbing all this stuff. That's fine. Got some diggable area over here that we haven't really messed with. Some extra algae. Look at the temperature on this algae. Wow. More rock. A lot of coal down here. Now, I assume... Let's click on this real quick. I hadn't clicked on this before. A mysterious and extremely resilient metallic element cannot be excavated by a duplicate. So this is the impenetrable area within the game. There's nothing we can do about it. It's just going to sit there and make us sad forever. And that's fine. I'm not really worried about it. Now, how you doing here, Puffs? Ah, good. Still doing your thing, I see. Now, how did you get out of here? Weren't they both stuck in here? Kind of odd. Probably one of our dudes probably went in there and grabbed the slime or something, and that's how they got in or out. Man, he is pooping slime everywhere, but I appreciate that. I don't mind. Go right ahead, baby. That's what I like to see. All right, so now these two things should be prepared. So let's go ahead and enable this building, and with these two things on, this is going to generate the evil scent. So, we're gonna see what happens here. I'm also gonna just mop this stuff up real fast. In fact, you know what? Let's mop this stuff up. I think that you can do a priority, on mopping. Or I believe you can. We're about to find out here. Grab some slime, put it in the biodistiller right up in there. You guys know how it is. A little bit more, I imagine. How's everything going on down here? Alright, we've got quite a bit of power stored up. Alright, so here we go. Hold on. Let's go over to oxygen here. Yes! Yes! It's freaking working. Now, how crazy is that? Hold on. Let's go over to... Where the hell's my plumbing overlay? Let's see here. Not gas plumbing. I want liquid plumbing. There we go. So right over here, you look at this. The disgusting fluids go into the electrolyzer, and then the electrolyzer pumps, as far as I know. Now, it looks like the only area that's shooting out sick, disgusting gases is over here by the biodistiller. So if we wanted to... We could probably like wall this off and put it inside of a little area. Like we could probably put it over here or something if we really wanted to, just away from everything else, so that it's not getting all of the disgusting air out, because you can see it's getting quite a bit of the nasty air. Now, there's a couple things that we can do about the nasty air. We could, if we wanted to, get rid of this floor lamp, for instance, and put these two deodorizers up here, which is totally fine. In fact, I may go ahead and do that, just because this one lamp is over here. I'll probably put, like, another lamp over here, because I'm pretty sure it can shine a lot of this down. Speaking of which, let's go and kind of get rid of this for right now, and we'll get rid of this for right now as well, just to get it out of there at some point. And, yes, we're gonna go ahead and deconstruct this, and then I'll sweep on over here to, oh, there's the air scrubber, by the by. We'll go ahead and sweep over here real quick, and we're gonna go put down one of these, and once this is gone, we'll put another one right there. All right, looks like it's nighttime. I'm gonna let everyone get a little bit of shut-eye, and I'll be back with you in the morning. All right, brand new day. We got a little bit of stress kind of going around right now. Well, a little bit. We got quite a bit of stress going on over here. We got the electrolyzer making a little bit of oxygen every once in a while, mostly just utilizing the biodistiller over here. We are starting to use this water kind of big time. So at this point, I'm kind of thinking about making that that shower. If you look over here, we still have a little bit of disgusting air kind of like looming around here and there. For the most part, these algae plants are doing pretty good. So that's kind of nice. I'm thinking about putting the shower like over here so that we can draw in the water right from this area. And then we can toss the crappy water right over here. I think that would probably be a good idea. In fact, what I might do is start digging this out a little bit more. We have some cool stuff over here, including just an epic ton. Just a ton of algae. So, right quick, I think what we'll do is we'll go ahead and put down a dig command. And we will, I think we're going to dig all the way this way so we can get this entire top portion all dug out. And what are we doing over here? The atmospheric pressure is too low. So, basically what we've got going on is this electrolyzer here just isn't getting enough from the biodistiller. I think that's kind of what we're stuck with. This puffed over here is still alive. I'm very surprised that he's still going. Not enough materials for the biodistiller. Okay, so for the most part, the biodistiller is fresh out of goo. So we're gonna have to take a look at just drawing from a different water source in order to make this work. And that's pretty much gonna be this down here. I think we're just gonna have a piping system going down this way so that we can draw from here. And plus, I mean, if we do make a shower, we'll be drawing from this as well. And then when we're done, we can draw from this one. And then when we're done with that, we can draw from this one. So it'll allow us to live for quite a little bit longer. How's the stress going? Entity and Rail Baron. I think both of them are getting the massages at the moment. That's Mr. Hart over there. Mr. Hart, how are you doing? Oh, you're at 34%, huh? I'm probably going to kick you off. I'm sorry to kick you off. But I'm probably going to kick you off and make this Rail Baron's table for the moment. Just so that Rail Baron can get a little bit happier. I've walled this off up here. Just so that we're not losing a lot of our atmospheric pressure that way. And I'm just kind of thinking about other things that I would like to do. I think I'm going to start building this way. And kind of put a wall of tiles, I should say. In fact, let's go ahead and do that. Let's kind of start building outward this way. We're going to take this granite and do, I don't know if I want to go that far. Right about like there. I want to do that. And then we're going to keep going and we're going to bring the granite down this way, like so. And then we will bring it this way, like so. Oh, we're going to have to rip all this out of here, aren't we? What do we have in here? We got some muckroot and some other stuff like that. Harvest. I'm actually just going to dig this stuff up to get it out of here. We got a bristle blossom. Let's go ahead and dig that up. Can you dig it? I wonder if there's, oh, right over here. We've got the ultimate dig command. Let's go get all this dug up real fast. And let me get this area kind of like cleaned up, and then we'll start turning this into a little containment unit. All right, our guys are working out pretty hard. I think our puffs kicked the bucket. I'm not really sure. But we have to get this taken care of. The atmospheric pressure problem is like now a legitimate problem. So what I'm going to need to look into doing is, in fact, we're going to have to dig through all of this. First off, just so that we have the area going down here, because we can't put a pipe through this, but we can put a pipe through tile. So let's go ahead and get all that dug out as soon as possible. I want to get this stifling taken care of, like ASAP. Can't believe we're out of slime so quickly. But I don't think that those critters poop that much slime. I think it just kind of like comes out fairly in little chunks. I don't know what else to call it. Their poop comes out in little chunklets, I guess. Now, the other thing that we could do, just to get the atmospheric pressure lined up, is I could make the algae thingy and get that done. But I think we'll be all right. I think we're going to pull this off in time. In fact, you know what? What else I could do is cancel that in the meantime, just so that they start getting this done. While they're going to be doing that, let's look over to our liquid pipes. Oh, there's so much going on. And you guys wonder how I miss stuff. Like, on top of all the craziness that goes on in this colony, I've got to freaking handle this crap. All right, so let's get this done here, put this down here. Then we're going to want, let's see. Let me think about this for a second. I think I'm going to need a pump all the way down here to do this. I imagine I am. So, all right, let me go ahead and continue fixing up this pumped area over here. We're going to do this out of, I guess we'll do it out of, well, we can do it out of any of these. Oh my God, we have a lot of rock. I guess I'll do it out of this rock down here, like this here. And then it will come straight down. And it will come into kind of this region here for right now. We're going to need another water pump down here. That's for damn sure. Let's make it out of, yeah, copper ore is fine. We'll put it right there. The conduits are starting to get made, which is good. Come on, baby. Get this crap done. Calories are going down. I've got to get this fixed up. Now, there's a lot of, like, meal lice just hanging on the ground over here. Now, what's it say? Hold on. Let me see if I can click on this. Does it say it's, like, not fresh? It's unrefrigerated. It's fresh. I'm really curious why stuff doesn't get stored in here that quickly. I'm kind of curious if it didn't have a high enough priority. Remember, guys, priority 9 for life, right? We're not messing around here. All right, now, if a little bit of water gets lost, it's not a big deal. I'm not super worried about that because it's going to go all the way down, potentially, if I decide to remove this area. This one piece of water here, there's just like a chunk of water. It's been sitting here forever. You guys going to do anything about this or what? we're going to need power as well going to this pump. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. Go grab our electrical wiring. And where is the quickest or where is the easiest wires that we have in this area? I guess we can do this over here. That's weird. We've got one little piece of ground that's kind of like sitting there doing nothing. Bring it over here and then we'll kind of go up this way. All right, so we got everything set up for the most part. I had to build a little bit of a platform down here so my dudes could actually like get to all this electrical wiring. Stress was getting a little out of hand, so we're kind of handling that at the moment. There is a bit of a food issue going on right now. And by a bit of a food issue, I mean there is a significant food issue at the moment. Let me go ahead and turn that off and give you ownership of this table for the moment. The problem was is that we had a lot of stifling going on. So, yeah, a lot of our plants wasn't growing because we just could not generate enough oxygen. And that, I think in the end, that's going to be our biggest downfall. We're on cycle 66 right now, which is pretty good. The issue is that, like, you can make it to, like, set, like, in the hundreds. But a lot of what we're doing here is we're playing the game just to kind of have fun and learn stuff. So this is very, very inefficient. Having 4 or 5 people would have been the best, but I wanted to get one more just to be able to kind of like name someone after one of you guys and show some, since you guys are showing so much support and stuff like that, let me get rid of all these people. Red Jack Shed. So keeping 4 people probably would have been the absolute best. But all right, come on now. Get me the energy that I need. Let me check this out. We should have all of this pretty much set up decently. Let me see here. I'm just kind of looking around just to make sure. Like I said, eventually one of the biggest things that we're going to want to do is block off all the walls inside of this thing so that we are not like throwing a lot of air elsewhere. Like I could probably, like, is there any reason for us to have like down here, for instance? Most likely not. So I think I'm going to go ahead and tile that off right now just because. We're going to go ahead and just like tie, oh Jesus, I don't need to tile all that. I just want to get like this portion tiled and that tiled and then deconstruct this. And we'll put an extra tile there in a little bit. But just get all that kind of tiled out. Stress down to 56 and 45, which still isn't great, but it's something. The electrolyzer here should easily begin helping all this. Okay, we've got 3,000 calories kind of like wandering around. Entity's sticking it out here, which is good, I guess. He's down to 24%, which ain't bad. We're going to have to make Ale probably sit over here for the rest of the day. Man, managing a lot of this stress is becoming annoying. Now, a lot of people are like, why are guys getting stressed as time goes on? I just see a lot of players kind of finding out that their guys absorb more and more stress as time goes on. I think that the game, like, as a difficulty level, has everyone just get more stressed the longer you play. And I think that's just, like, a part of the game. So I think what happens is a lot of people end up killing off a lot of their little duplicates so that they can deal with the stress a little bit better. And that is a thing. We could do that, I guess. I don't want to have to do that. I don't want to have to put these guys under the knife. Well, it's not really the knife. It's actually kind of, I guess it would be euthanizing them in CO2. I don't know if you would consider that very nice, but that's what we would do. I'm going to continue to do this over here, just kind of, like, dig all this area out. Now, even if I dig all this out, this, like, this much here isn't that big of a colony. If we keep this area like this, it's not, like, grotesquely huge or anything like that. It's pretty big, but it's not, like, enormous, especially when it comes to this many people that we, or this few amount of people that we have. It's just really not that many duplicates. Keep it going, boys. Atmospheric pressure is looking much, much better nowadays, especially since this thing continues to run. Like I said, the biggest issue is whether or not we're going to find enough goo to purify. And in fact, I may have to start, like, coring this area out, just kind of, like, making a little drop hatch here so that we can start moving all the disgusting water into this, which would certainly help. Coal generator has been working fantastically. Every once in a while, a little manual generator guy has to sit up here. I know someone mentioned that my guys keep on having to jump off because of the CO2. This thing generates a huge amount of CO2 because you're running in the same place forever. So, I mean, I could put this, for instance, like, I could put it up here and allow him to do it that way. That's, I mean, we could do that if we wanted to. So, like I said, a shower, it's going to end up, man, it's going to end up using the crap out of our stuff, out of our water. And we're already kind of low on water right now. I almost feel like I want to stabilize the colony before I start worrying about that. How much more growing time do we have? Ooh, 83%. Yeah, see, we got a little bit of growing time left, guys. 81%, 79. And we have very, very few calories right now. We've got a couple more seeds laying around. The seed issue is a non-issue. We've got tons of seeds. Too bad we can't eat algae somehow. Can't find a way to somehow eat the algae. I can probably turn this off as well. We don't need these going at the moment because we're not going to be down here for a little while. Let's see. What else do I want to do? I think I'm just going to worry about stabilizing our oxygen levels right now. Now, it looks like the puff just kind of died and then disappeared into the nether. So I don't really know, like, where he went or what he did or anything like that. That puff is freaking gone. He's out of here. He's no longer with us. And let's see, 88%, 500 calories right now. So everyone's probably going to be getting fairly hungry soon. 31%, Indy Sage is the highest level. So I'm going to get you down. I'm going to put Indy Sage on here for right now. I'm mostly just going to kind of care for this at the moment. And like I said, now the balance is going to be using this to make just enough air so that I can turn this off afterward. Well, everyone's gonna go to sleep right now, but turn this off and then just kind of, like, keep going back and forth and back and forth so we can use our water as best possible, because this thing's pretty efficient, but it's gonna burn through water kind of quick. Anyway, guys, I'll see you in the morning. All right, it's a brand new day. We've got a couple of pieces of food that are gonna get made, which we definitely need to do because everyone is very, very hungry right now. And we're going to have to keep a close eye on the atmospheric pressure. Oh, here we go. Hold on. Let me go ahead and just harvest this real quick. For the most part, everyone's just kind of sweeping up right now, which I'm totally fine with. I'm going to let these guys sweep everything up. Go ahead and do this. There we go. Starting to get a little bit more food, which is good. How close is everything else? Ah, 99%. Okay, excellent. So we've managed to basically stave off starvation yet again for the moment. What else could we do? We could start destroying all these paintings and try and, like, remake the paintings. But like I said, first things first is I think I want to get our, I think I want to get our little bit of a shower going on here. Now, other things to do to make this shower is we could build in here. I could knock this wall out here. The only issue is if I knock this wall out, that's going to make a bunch more, like, atmospheric area that could happen. Well, I guess there's no way really to stop that. I guess we can stop it when we rebuild the wall, which is fine. So let's go ahead and just kind of dig this area out so these guys can finish up in here. In fact, you know what? We'll go ahead and prioritize. Oh, that's not what I want to do. We'll go ahead and prioritize some of this. We're going to get this done. I'm going to let them build this up real fast. I think it's still a... Oh, okay, it's a 9. I'm going to let them finish this up real fast. There we go. Good, good, good. Get that crap done, baby. Get all this built out. Dig up this muck root and stuff like that, too. Because there's a little bit more food hanging around here. Let's go ahead and get a sleep command going. Just, there might be some other sleeps or other sweep stuff that we need to do. Now, I'm pretty sure we're going to need a ladder going down here for the moment. In fact, I'm very, very sure of it. So let's go ahead and get that done. Yeah, look at how much crap is just laying around. This is just stuff that, like, we've had for a while. We haven't really had to touch because there's been so many other important things to do. And, like, now is the time where I may finally be able, now that we've done most of what we wanted to do, I might finally be able to get ourselves, like, working on, like, you know, like I said, like, kind of making the colony look a little bit better. Now, to be fair, we're stuck underground here, guys. I mean, this place isn't supposed to look beautiful. We're on some foreign freaking celestial body. We don't even know where the hell we are. We're just trying to survive. So, I mean, there is that. Let me go ahead and dig all of this as well, like that. Just get all that done over there. There's even more algae over here, I do believe. Yeah, there is. There is. I'm probably going to want to put down another ladder just so that everyone can get up here if they need to. There we go. Okay, so everyone's going to sleep for right now. I'm going to be back with you guys in the morning. We're going to get this pocket dug out. And then I think we'll finally be ready for our shower. Morning's upon us. Oxygen level's not terrible. We don't have a lot of contaminated air, which I kind of like right now. Again, not that the contaminated air does like a lot, but I don't know. It does something. So there is that. Let's go ahead and get this finished up, guys. Come on, dig all this crap out so I can finish this kind of stuff up. We do need a ladder here so that we can continue to dig this. And in fact, I may even need to like mess around over here and make another little shelf or something. Just so that everyone can kind of move this way. In fact, you know what? We'll make the shelf for now. Like I said, it's not really a big deal. We've got the space. And we have the materials. Lord knows we have the materials. And there's more materials coming every second here. You can see tons of dirt and granite and all kinds of crap. Cycle 69, man. 69! The cycles are coming and going real fast. Not mop. We will. You guys can sweep this at your leisure. I'm not worried about it. We can turn this air deodorizer off. I don't think that we need it right now. So let's go ahead and do that. Are you guys almost done here? Almost. They just have a little bit more digging to do. Little bit more digging. One more over here and that'll finally be done. So go ahead and get it, baby. Get it. Yeah. Come on. Do it, you beautiful little bastards. Yes. And then we'll probably just get rid of this ladder altogether. As long as this guy can get out. Yep, there we go. Okay, good. So he is out. We can go ahead now and deconstruct this, assuming he doesn't go flying off, come to think of it. Let's do that like that. There we go. Okay, now that's done, I'll let him sweep all this up just because. Oh, another duplicate. I think we're going to go ahead and just let those pass by. None of them have the beautiful thing that I love anyway, so I'm not too worried about that. Come on, guys, get all the stuff picked up. Our storage room still doing okay. Our food is looking, wow, our food is looking much, much better now. 17,000 calories. So we're getting a little bit of a store so that when I start to see the atmospheric pressure not doing good enough, I can have enough time to deal with all this. This is going to look pretty good. This should be almost perfect. In fact, I may even want to put my, my special door up here. In fact, you know what? That's probably a pretty good idea. Let me let everyone go to sleep. Let's go ahead and dig this area out like this, right here. And then we'll probably put our containment door. What the hell is that called? The airlock, right? Yeah, the manual airlock. We'll probably put a manual airlock here sideways. And I think that'll work for everything that we need. And there'll be a ladder up here so that people can do maintenance or, I don't know, do whatever they might have to do down here. And that should be good enough. All right, man, there we go. Now we finally got the room all set up. So we can put a shower up here if we wanted to. In fact, let me go over here to the plumbing. Now, a shower. I've never messed with a shower. So let's put it one section over on this side. In fact, yeah, copper ore. That's what I want to make it out of. I wanted to grab all the crap out of here, too, so that, like, later on, if we're putting contaminated water in here, like, no one, like, randomly came in here to try and pick something up. That would have been terrible. They'd be, like, neck deep in contaminated water. That would be absolutely disgusting. This probably uses a lot of copper ore. 13,000 calories right now. Not too shabby. Okay, so there it is. There's our little shower. So let's start getting the pipes in place here. All right, boys, shower's fixed up. I wanted to show you guys something. So there's a few things that I found out. I wanted to share that information with you, and I kind of wanted to show you what I'm doing with this. This has got to be a bug or something, but it's working out amazingly. So we've got some contaminated water kind of going on in here. You boys know how it is, looking pretty good. Now, there's something that myself and I guess this is a thing. I think this happens to everyone. The water bridge. So why am I not using a water bridge for this? Supposedly, the water bridge loses you material for some reason. I don't know if it's a calculation, there's a round up, round down thing going on, but you definitely don't get the same amount of fluid coming into it as you do when it comes out of it. So I hate it. But there's something that you can do. So let's go over here to the liquid overlay. Boom shakalaka. Now right down here, you're gonna notice that I have clean water going in here, right into the shower. And then the shower's throwing out some contaminated water. A couple pieces down here and one piece over here. This is very interesting. Watch this. What happens? Okay. So the electrolyzer, right? It seems that the way the electrolyzer works is if it decides that there is something moving around in the pipe, it will throw. Here, watch. See how every once in a while, right there, it will emit oxygen as long as it feels that there's something in the pipe. So what happens is, these two little pieces, look at this, they jimmy jive back and forth like this here. This can't be normal. Look at this. They're like, and it still keeps working. It says empty pipe, but it's very clearly bringing out breathable oxygen, which is amazing, because essentially what that means is I could keep this thing going for quite some time. Now, one of you guys mentioned that we can put this gas pump anywhere. It doesn't have to be stuck on the floor, which is frickin' incredible. In fact, while I remember, let's go ahead and start harvesting all this. So that's what we're gonna do. Now, look at this. It's like, what was that? It's like one piece of water in there. That was very unusual. I'm watching this. Now, there should only be disgusting water coming out here. Yeah, there's only disgusting water coming out there. That was kind of unusual. But this thing just continues to gurgle. It continues to gurgle out oxygen. And it's like, I mean, it's working. It's very clearly working. But anyway, at least I think it's working. So I just wanted to show you guys that. If nothing else, it just shows to go you that you can use the shower and you don't need a bridge or any, or you don't have to do all kinds of like crazy pipage. All you have to do is just have the one pipe going in and then the one pipe going out. And even if you do get some craptastic water going into your electrolyzer, well, your electrolyzer just straight up doesn't care. I don't know why, it just doesn't care. So that's pretty awesome. So that's working out well. Oh, other thing too. We found out that, like, let's say you make walls down here, and I wall all this in. Every time a wall is created where there's a chunk of water, it will completely obliterate this chunk of water, meaning this chunk of water gets destroyed. It doesn't get redistributed in the water area. It gets annihilated. So that's why I don't want to build a pocket around this. Like, if I did build a pocket around it, we could build it like this, like one away. Then we could just dig all this out and we could have our pocket that way. But what you don't want to do is build walls in the middle, like here, because if you do this, for instance, what's going to happen is they're going to destroy the wall, the water's going to fill it in, and then they're going to create a tile there, and it's going to destroy all that water. Anyway, I just wanted to share that with you guys as well. You guys always give me a lot of fantastic tips and stuff, and every once in a while, I'd like to see if I can give you guys a tip as well. But anyway, the shower is working. People are starting to, is there anyone here that's managed to use it all the way? Let me check real quick. No one's used it all the way yet. Oh, look at this right here. What was that? Little dude over there went to use it for like 2 seconds. And then he was like, that's good enough for me. This is like the quickest showers I've ever seen. They shower for like 10 seconds and then they're done. I wonder if it's because of the... No, there's good oxygen over here. I was gonna say, I was curious if it was because there was disgusting oxygen over there, but there's not. Everyone's just like very, very slightly showering. They do not want to shower all the way. Let's go ahead and harvest this. Now, our harvestable goods, looking at 10.5k calories right there. We've got a ton of seeds, which I am so very, very thankful for. The seeds are looking fantastic. Y'all still grimy? Yeah, still grimy for now. Now, what we can do is we can continue to probably distill this and then bring it back over here. Now, here's what I'm curious about. If the bridge destroys water, I wonder if as the water is split between this liquid pipe and this liquid pipe, so the dirty water, if things round up and we can get a little bit extra water in there. Ooh, look at all this. Look at all this stress. I'm gonna have to get some folks on here. Who else was really stressed out? Was it Indy Sage? Indy Sage, man, you have been a poor stressed bastard for quite some time. But eventually, you guys won't be grimy any longer. If you decide to stay in the shower for more than 1 second. I'm not 100% sure why that is. I think eventually, once they're not so busy. Oh, you know why? Hold on. I wonder, is there a priority on this thing? No, there's not. Huh. There's not a priority on a shower. That's very strange. I would have thought there would have been, but I guess not. All right. Well, either way, they are at the very least getting a little bit of showering in. I think they just have to get it all the way to make it work. Now, this is interesting. Our guys are picking up disgusting water, and look at this. They're using it inside of the algae terrarium, and it's just showing up as good, clean water. This is really, really strange. I'm not really sure why that works like that, but whatever. Oh, and finally, look at this. They're finally getting enough showering in. They only shower for like 2 seconds, but look. AL199 game is now totally clean. He's no longer grimy. So our freaking shower works. Not only does it work to fill this area up over here. This is interesting. We've got like a weird divot over here. But it also like consistently powers our electrolyzer forever. Forever. It's awesome. At least it appears like it is. Guys, hope you're enjoying Oxygen Not Included. We've got a working shower. We also have got a lot of food. I got to start. We're going to have to get a second refrigerator. Jesus. Anyway, folks, until next time, stay foxy and much love.